These are some of the forgotten electromagnetics textbooks. They are old, that is, they were published between 1970 and 1980. And they are special in their own respect. I just want to introduce them and show some pages of them. And the contents of all these textbooks are pretty standard. That is, they go in the order of electrostatics, electromagnetics, then time-varying phenomena, that is introducing Maxwell's equations. And they go into other applications and wave equations, wave propagation, antennas, waveguides, etc. Pretty standard old textbooks, but they are special in their own respect. First, I will start with the textbook by Electromagnetics by Cross and Carver. This is in second edition. Now, the fifth edition of this textbook is available with the title Electromagnetics with Applications. And this textbook is beginner friendly in many ways. It has mathematical depth, but it doesn't go into detailed mathematical derivations of everything it tries at. And some pages I will show. As you can see, this page, these two few pages, it has a list of all important equations of electromagnetics given in few pages at the starting of this book. This is the only textbook I saw which has such thing, like a tutorial for a beginner. And Cross, and that is the authors, mentioned that a beginner should be able to explain this phenomena and need to come back and refer to these equations frequently. You can see how beginner friendly the textbook will be to learn the electromagnetics if you are a beginner. And next, I will go to this textbook by Paul and Nazar. These two authors are from Berkeley, UC Berkeley. And this textbook is also pretty standard, and I don't see anything special about the contents of this textbook. It covers transmission lines and antennas to some extent and all electromagnetic fields. But in my opinion, it has detailed explanations for most of the equations, and very detailed explanations which are lacking in other textbooks. And they wrote it well. For a beginner, it's a good textbook. And then next comes this textbook by Carson and Loren, Electromagnetic Fields and Waves. I admired this textbook for its figures, actually. It was published around, I think, 1986. And the pictures depicting the electromagnetic phenomena in this textbook are wonderful. At that time, how they managed to get them, I don't know. But this book will be forever for its these pictures it has. For example, you can see here in the beginning of the electrostatic fields, chapter 3, there is a picture showing the boundary conditions between two media. And I will show you many such pictures. And here is a picture showing the electromagnetic fields, that is the field around a charge in the vicinity of a sphere. And here you can see the Hall effect in semiconductors, that is how electrons and holes behave when electric field is applied and also magnetic field is present. Here is a picture of the electromagnetic fields in a rectangular waveguide. And here is a picture of the radiation from a two-element dipole array. There are many such wonderful figures in this textbook, innumerable. And how wonderful it is in explaining all these phenomena through pictures is amazing. You can find this textbook amazing. And it also deals with concepts of relativity and wave generation, that is electromagnetic field generation from accelerated charges, etc. In that sense, this is a book worth considering at least once by any beginner. And next comes this textbook, and this wonderful textbook, Applied Electromagnetics. This textbook is actually more concentrated on the applications of electromagnetic fields. It actually deals with the basics of electromagnetics, and it is just up to the point and explains how those are used in different applications. I will show you a few examples here. For example, you can see here the oscilloscope, that is a CRT monitor, that is the how the charged particles behave in the presence of electromagnetic fields. And another one is about the Van Allen belts, that is how the electrons and ions behave in the Van Allen belts in the geomagnetic field, how they travel between the North Pole and South Pole. And this one is about magneto-hydrodynamic power generation. And such many applications are present in this textbook. It is just up to the point. You don't expect much explanations of the electromagnetic laws, etc. But, and again, a book worth considering by any beginner and also advanced student also. And the last book is by Electromagnetic Fields by Wangsness. This is my favorite textbook, beginner textbook. And in my opinion, this is nothing less when compared to the textbook by Griffiths today. It has detailed explanations. The way he has put it in words, the electromagnetic phenomena, is wonderful. And many people have forgotten about this one. And it is not being at least referred in many textbooks also. But for a beginner, this is a wonderful textbook, no doubt.